Real quick history, I wrote this piece back in 2011 for a group called Rutsubotaiko, and it premiered in January 2012 at Boston Children's Museum. It's really, really valuable for you as your group is playing it to add your own meaning to it and to use this as a storytelling vehicle. But I can tell you a little bit about what I was thinking and feeling when I wrote it and what the song has come to mean to me since then. My playlist at the time was a lot of electronic music, little skittery beats, mostly programmed on computers. I had the sense that these things were not playable by human hands. Meanwhile, I was starting to really fall in love with taiko. I mean kumidaiko, not just the drums themselves, but the community of players who, through teamwork, can achieve something truly beautiful and amazing. Since you have multiple people contributing to putting a rhythm together, maybe we could be as awesome as computers who are trying to do superhuman things. I also really love dance, and I love that taiko gives us a way to both be making music and dance at the same time. So I had this grand idea that there would be a drum machine humanoid robot who, over the course of the song, would sort of go from drum and bassy little skittery beats to these big, long, wide hits that have more dance, more ma, and would thereby become human. That's not the arrangement of how the song has turned out to be so far, but I think that core element of our drum machine humanoid robot has stayed with us. So that's the surface story of what's going on in the piece, but in terms of what it means to me and where my feelings are coming from, my concept of being Asian in America, in this world. And so for me, there's this trajectory representing assimilation, of feeling very rigid, very limited, and over time breaking out of these bonds and finding peers who care about me for who I am and not just what I look like, where I'm also able to let loose and have fun. Being able to have fun and be seen as an interesting, deep character as opposed to just a stereotype is so much of what it means to become human. So that's another meaning of become human. Now, you don't have to be Asian. I just urge each person to find their own story to go along with it, of what it means for them to become human. Basically, everyone in this world has had to hustle for respect. What does it mean to you to come into your full potential? What does it mean for you to be really seen? Let's talk about rights. So this piece is released under Creative Commons with the restrictions of BY and SA. BY means you have to attribute the creators. So that's me and Mazine Leitner. And SA means share alike. So you can earn money off this. You can remix this. You can do all sorts of things you want with this, but whatever you make, you can't put more restrictions on. Like, you can't release something under any more restrictive license than CC BY SA. So my understanding of that is that you can get money from ticket sales, you can pay to teach this song to someone else, but you can't tell someone else that they can't teach it unless they pay you. That's a violation. Resources. So there's a whole Kuchishoka spreadsheet and song flow sheet on Google Sheets, linked from the website. You can see that there's different colors used to indicate the different kinds of hits. The darkness of the colors can give you a sense of their relative dynamics. If you mouse over some of the cells, it has some clues in it, anticipating some of your questions perhaps and indicating like where things are optional. So this spreadsheet contains the shimedaiko part, the chudaiko part, and the fue part as well. On YouTube, there's a video for Shime, a few chudaiko videos covering the portion, and then two joint Shime and chudaiko videos. So it's like two parallel tracks merging. Fue, you're kind of on your own. Basically, there's the notation and there's a slow version of me playing it. There's a fast version of me playing it along with the ending theme. So you can see how it fits in. This piece was originally written with three chudaiko players in mind and a shime player, maybe two. But now it's been retooled for one shimedaiko player and one chudaiko player because that's what's possible. And there wasn't originally a fue player, but I will say that the melody that the fue player plays was in my head as I was writing theme. It just took me most of a decade to learn an instrument and be able to actually put that melody out there. But that kind of crooning, slow, luxurious vibe alongside the little skittery beats, that contrast was something that I really liked. However many players you have, I think it's important that each player have a coherent story that they're contributing toward the whole. There can be parts that expand beyond the four walls of the story. This part is currently playing the narrator or something, and if they're playing multiple parts, whatever they're doing on each part should also contribute to that story. So what I mean by this is that the stories can actually overlap. So in the most recent performance we did, the two of us were protesters, and one of us had been locked in jail. And so, as the dancer being locked in jail, I was working on fighting my way out of the chains and out of confinement. The other person was trying to find me and be able to bring me home to safety, make sure I'm nourished and well taken care of. So that story was in one person's mind, while in another person's mind, we have all this about me being a robot chained up and escaping those confines and finding human friends and thus becoming human. Each person can think about the different roles that they play, and I think that really adds something to the depth of the piece. Do you need to have a dancer? No, you don't need to have a dancer, but I do think that you should dance as much as you can in this piece. I wrote these rhythms to be danceable. They inspire me to dance, and I hope they inspire you to dance too. But I realized that dance is my expressive art form of choice. It's one of my ways that I feel that I can do my best storytelling. So you should think about what that is for you. It could be some kind of video, it could be singing, it could be other instruments, it could be wine and cheese pairing. Maybe you should give the audience some cheese. Whatever you find the most expressive and whatever helps you tell your story, I think you should go for it. I do hope that I've created a piece that helps break down the boundaries between dance and taiko as supposedly separate art forms. I'm really grateful to my first taiko teacher, Bruce Muigent. Mui Sensei is an amazing dancer and choreographer and composer. I think the way that he uses new pieces to, send messages out into the world about stories that need to be told, is something that's been a huge inspiration to me.